Whoa, this is a very very big tree and nice view. So guys, I'm in Tannirmukkam Bund. Tannirmukkam is the place name and Bund means a barrier. So just this is that Tannirmukkam Bund. So this is something which is created to protect the salt water entering the Vembanad Lake. Vembanad Lake is a fresh lake, and Vembanad Lake is the one of the longest lake in India, and this is the largest lake in Kerala. So this is a very beautiful location, so I thought of sharing this area with you guys in this vlog. So this is a beautiful morning, and we have some quite good view. So the sun is rising, the time is around 7 a.m. in the morning. I thought of coming here to have a morning walk, because this beautiful view, scenery, and this climate. Kerala is having the monsoon, but right now for the last 2 days it's very sunny day. So here the people, most of the people are living over here, comes for jogging and all. So this gives a refreshing mindset. So that's the thing, because occupied to your home, because you know in Kerala the lockdown is still going on, the corona cases is not coming down. So I will show some footages again here. So this is called, this is spread across different districts of Kerala. In Alappuzha or in Kottayam, this area, this is called as Vembanad Lake. In Alappuzha or Kuttanad area, this is called as Punyamada Kayal or Punyamada Lake. And in when it goes to the Kochi or Ernakulam city, it is known as the Kochi Lake. So in the last vlog, I have covered the Fort Kochi area, the Mattancheri and the Waipin Island. So that particular lake is also under this, so that is called Kochi Lake in that area. So this is the area you are seeing, that is the Alappi district or the Alappuzha district. The Chertala side, the people come from that side, and straight away this barrier or this bund takes it to the Kottayam. So that end, that is a Kottayam district or the Kottayam city, the people can commute. So not only this will protect the salt lake entering to the Vembanad Lake, but this is also the main commutation or the main intersection, inter point, the bridge which connects the people commuting between Alappuzha district way to Kottayam. Let's go to other side of that and see some scenic view, what we can see. The people are started fishing and they are putting the baits, and there are a lot of things happening here. So this is a good area. If you are in and around Alappuzha district, you can come over here and explore this area. It's quite a beautiful place. We can see a few brothers standing over here and fishing. This is a very good place to catch some good fish. Okay, so okay, here they got a chambali, I think. This is a chambali and this is prawns. So not a bad thing in this morning. They had a good catch. So see how he is putting it across. Oh, it's going so far, yeah. That's nice. Few people are going in the boats as well. Quite interesting to see in this early morning. This kind of views will give something refreshing, quite obvious. Wow. I wish they will get more. So let's move. So we were standing over that area till the time, and people started putting the baits. Let's move to the other location. This is the west side of that river, and this is also a very awesome view. A lot of fishing boats, the small boats. Quite scenic, isn't it? So there are a lot of ecological problems also after constructing this barrier. So the ecological problem is that because of this, the flow of water to the sea has been restricted, because now depending upon the paddy field cultivation only, this will be opened or allowed the water to flow. So because of that, a lot of water hyacinths, in Malayalam we call payal, that got accumulated. Lot of river weeds also got breeding here. Because of that, it polluted the river. The river pollutants things coming from the industries and the hospitals also is getting blocked in this area. So this area is getting polluted, I mean the inner part of this river. So that's also making a very ecological concern. And also the fishing community reports that because the salt water is not allowed to enter into this area, the different kinds of fishes needs the salt water to breed. That's not happening. So it's affecting the fishing population or the variety of fishes in this location. So that's another concern. And the paddy fields, one interesting thing is that this river is going across the Kuttanad area. And Kuttanad is, if you search in the Google, you can see that this one area in the whole world where the paddy cultivation or the rice cultivation is happening below the sea level. Yeah, it is below the sea level. That means that area, the altitude is below the sea level. So you can imagine how this will be happening. So that's very interesting to see. If you go to the Alappi side in Alappuzha district, you must visit the Kuttanad area and see the paddy cultivation. So that's very interesting to watch. And the best time is around this time, because in Kerala, Onam is the best time to see. And around July, August, this time if you go to that area, you can see that kind of cultivation, which will be well harvested. And there are a lot of resorts also, dependent on this banks of this river. And that area is called Kumaragam. And we have a lot of tourists, foreigners, visiting this location because of this mind-blowing resort and the facilities provided in that resort. Because the food, mainly the food, the river food which we get from this area is very yummy or delicious. So the people who stays in resorts will get a variety of menus of food items which is directly catched from this river. So that's the main source of livelihood or the sustenance of the people who is staying around in and around this area. Quite beautiful. This area is something related to opening of the shutters of this barrier or the bunt or the supporting structure to this area. And this area, I think this is for jumping down to the river for getting suicide. I'm just kidding. But there is a gap to enter this area. So if one wish and feel the life is now meaningless, you can just jump and get suicide. So that's on a light note. I'm very much refreshed, literally saying. It's too awesome area, and especially in this climate and in this daytime and also in the evening also the sun will be in the worst side. Right now it's in the east, obviously it's a morning, so in the evening and as well as in the morning time, this is the best place to visit to have some kind of good cherishing memories. You can take it from here. So awesome view. So there are a lot of islands also located in this river. So one is one of that kind is called the Padira Manal. I will show you that manal. We can have a slight view of that island from this area. So if you see in that location, that is the Padira Manal island. There is earlier the people used to settle there, but right now there is not a single individual living in that island. The main reason is that has been vacated by the government, or the people are relocated to a different location, mainly for the migratory birds to come and settle in that location. So at some point of in the year, there will be a lot of birds which come and reside in that Padira Manal location. So if the boating is there, because if you go to the Annapurna, we get a lot of tourist boat to navigate in and around this Vembanad or the Punyamada lake. So we will get a chance to go to that island and see the flora and fauna of that location as well. But unfortunately, because of the lockdown in Kerala, we are not able to get any boat service. The Kerala government itself has a lot of boat service, which is very cheap. In 400 rupees, you can spend 5 hours in entire cruise over this lake. And from morning 11 a.m. to till 5 a.m., I think you will get the good view of the entire location. And in Punyamada Lake, going straight away that way, the Nehru Trophy boat race also happens every year during the Onam time. But right now, again, because of the COVID reason, for the last two, this year also, this boat race is not there. It was very eye-catching, or the breathtaking views of the boat race, very big boats which compete each other. That was very beautiful. A lot of foreigners visit at this time Kerala to see this kind of boat race. I thought of watching and making a vlog out of it if that would have happened, but unfortunately we are not also lucky, because the government recently said that this time the Punyamada boat race is not going to happen. So let's see, next year probably we'll get rid of this virus and life will be normal, hopefully. So that's it. So I thought of coming here and showing this view with you guys. So hope you guys have enjoyed this view. If you are in and around this area, you should definitely come and visit this area. And that's it. So let's end this video. In Kerala, we are still struggling to get out of this virus. The cases are coming up. So pray for us and take care and bye bye. See you in the next vlog.